The advantage of using Google Sheets and sharing files is that you can collaborate with others in real time, and multiple users can work on the same file. There is no version confusion. Let's learn how to share your files in different ways and set up access levels, as well as how to protect your files from unknown editors changing your worksheets. We definitely don't want that. When you hover over the share icon next to your avatar in the upper right corner, if the file has a lock on it and says private to only me, it means that the file has not been shared with anyone. If you click on the share button, you will be able to share your file in two ways, either by giving access to G Drive, or you can create a link that you can share. In the box at the top, add people or groups. You can paste someone's email address or pick from a list of people you previously shared files with. You can notify others via email that you are sharing a file with them. If you don't notify them, they will still have access to the file and the file will show up in their G Drive, but they just might not know about it. In the top right corner, you can specify whether you want the people listed to have a viewer, commenter, or editor access. Viewers can't edit or comment on your file. Commenters can only comment but can't edit, and editors can make changes to your file. Additionally, if you click the settings option in the top right corner, you can modify the editor and viewer access further. You can set a limit so that editors could edit your file but not share the file or change permissions. Finally, you can also limit the viewers from being able to download, print, or copy the file. This is very important because if you have any hidden tabs, once viewers make a copy or download your file, they will be able to unhide them. Very few people know that, and I will show you how that works later. Let's go back to our file, and I'm going to hide one tab to show you later on how viewers could access it, even in this limited role. Let's go to my Gmail in my testing account. Because I opted for the notification, an email was sent with the link to the file. However, people who are not notified, they also have the file available in their G Drive. If you just click on Shared with Me on the left side, you will see all the files that someone shared with you. I can see the 2000 global companies worksheet there. If I open my email, I can see a preview of the file and can open it from here. When I open the file, at the top, I see that my role is set as a viewer with a view-only mode, letting me know that I can't edit this file. However, if I click on it, I can request edit access from the owner, which means an email will be sent to request it. I'm going to request an access and include a brief message. In the meantime, I will try to edit and delete data in the file. But I can't because I'm just a viewer. Once the file is shared, at the top, you have a list of people who have access to it. The list can include anonymous users if the file was shared without restrictions. There is a chat option to communicate with other users and the owner. I can send a message requesting editor access. On the other side, I can read the chat message and respond. If I want to change the level of access, I can hover over the sharing icon and see that the file is currently shared with one person. What is great is that all the different levels of access are listed here and I can modify them without having to start from zero. I'm going to change the access for Aki's lab as a commenter. I know she will not be happy about it as she asked to be an editor, but that's what we are going to do for now. On Aki Lab's side though, I still see the view only mode and can edit or comment. What you have to do is refresh the file for the new access to work. Now the mode changed to comments only and I can provide a comment. The moment I add a comment, it appeared on the owner side and I can see it when I hover over the cell. Let's say I feel pretty accommodating today and so I will grant Aki Lab editor access. Now any changes that Aki Lab's account makes appear pretty instantaneously on other users' side. Okay, I can see that the lab editor made poor choices and messed up my file, so I can go back to the access setting area and remove access. I may not even notify the person about it, and they would be making changes to the file, etc., but once they try to refresh it, a warning message would let them know that they lost access and need to request it again. Once the owner receives a request to access the file again, I can either share or decline it. Sometimes you may be managing a file but you no longer want to, or someone else is taking over the project. So you can transfer the ownership of the file to someone else. You will send them an invitation to take the ownership. They can either accept it or decline it. If they accept the ownership, they will now be listed as the owner and you will be listed as an editor. The second way to share your files is with a link. Click on the General Access and specify whether you want the link to be restricted or anyone with the link can access the file. The restricted access requires that you add users in the upper section to actually open the file through the link. If you select the Anyone with the link setting, you can still specify the role of everyone who will receive the link. You can set the role for others as viewers, commenters, or editors. Once I select the viewer role and copy the link, it means that whomever gets the link won't be able to edit my file and see any hidden tabs. But if I have not changed the viewer settings, they would be able to copy or download it and then easily see the hidden tabs, because at this point, they are the owners of the copy. So you can go back to the settings and make a change to this option to make sure you protect any sensitive hidden information. Now let me show you what can happen when you are not careful with sharing your files. If I create a link that anyone can access and set their role as editor, I will paste it now into incognito window to test it. You can see that I am able to delete data. Anyone can share and reshare this link and edit information in your file. So you want to be very careful when you create a link that anyone can access with editor role. Finally, sometimes you may want to share a file as a template or force others to make a copy of it before they view it. You can also do that. To set this up, go to Share, set General Access to anyone with the link, then set it with a viewer role and copy the link. Now, what we will need to change is the ending of our link. Instead of the portion that starts with Edit, we will replace it with Template/Preview. So this would be the link I would share with the changed ending. Whoever gets it will be prompted to use the file as a template. As an alternative, you can prompt people to open your file as a copy by changing the ending of your link to copy. Once others open the link, they will be prompted to make a copy of the file. Their new file name will start with the copy of, then the original file name. Thanks so much for watching.